So I always like to start with the slide, who will benefit from this presentation? And managers who have previously struggled at promoting financial planning and analysis, enterprise performance management, and integrating business analytics into their decision support systems. Managers who intend to champion any or all enterprise performance management and business analytic improvement techniques, and they need a compelling call to action. And the reason I have champion in quotation marks is because it's been my observation that although it's nice to have senior executive sponsorship for new initiatives and programs, often the executives at the C-suite are preoccupied or distracted with firefighting or short-term priorities. And it's typically managers that are one, two, three, four levels down from the executive suite that sort of have fire in the belly passion and ask themselves, how long do we want to perpetuate using some of these stale or archaic or traditional methods? And those are the people I really enjoy appealing to, because they will then basically do some sort of proof of concept or pilot project or rapid prototyping technique and demonstrate to their colleagues and even their executives the value of the methods we're going to describe. And I want to manage everyone's expectations. This next 75 minutes will be like an MBA curriculum, a two-year MBA curriculum in just 75 minutes, and you'll see how it happens. So I start with three questions. What, so what, then what? I tell organizations, you know, if you've successfully implemented one of the methods we're going to talk about today, such as strategy maps and balance scorecard or profitability analysis using activity-based costing principles, I say celebrate for one day. You are not done, because there's going to be so much information that you've not seen before. You're going to have to figure out what's relevant. That's the so what. But the most important question is the third one, then what? Because decisions only impact the future, and we want to know the impact of those decisions. And we will talk about that when we start talking about marginal and incremental expense analysis, what-if scenarios, and the like. So my agenda is I'm first going to clarify the confusion and lack of consensus about what is enterprise performance management or corporate performance management. They're actually synonymous. Then I will briefly discuss business analytics, because it's such a hot topic. I was fortunate to have an operations research degree from Cornell. I tell everyone I'm an engineer masquerading as an accountant, but I also have an analytics background. And then the bulk of the presentation will be about what I refer to as the eight pressures that have caused enterprise performance management interest, because as you'll see, these methods we're going to talk about have been around for decades, arguably even before computers, so they're not new. The question is, why is there interest? And then I'll bring it all together at the end. So let's get going. I think this cartoon sets the stage for the talk, drowning in data but starving for information. You have this poor, beleaguered clerk, sad-faced, shoulders hunched, paper all around him, and the supervisor at the left in the doorway is asking him, it looks like you have all the data. What is the holdup? I gave you the request this morning. Why don't you have the answer? And that's part of the dilemma with the big data issue. So I mentioned there is confusion and lack of consensus about enterprise performance management. Is it human resources performance management? Actually, if you Google just performance management, the majority of the hits will be HR and personnel, you know, employee appraisals. And the problem there is authors like me, and there's a few others, David Axon at Accenture, for example, we forgot and neglected to put the enterprise or the corporate adjective in front of it. Is it about scorecards, dashboards, KPIs, key performance indicators and measures, as well as alignment of the employees with the strategy, the executives? Yes, but that's just a subset of enterprise performance management. Is it process, productivity, and quality improvement? Yes, but that's business process management. Process. We're talking about a larger umbrella, enterprise performance management. So BPM fits in under enterprise performance management. So is it these above and even more? The answer is yes. And the good news is this. Enterprise performance management is not a new method or process or system that you and employees and managers have to learn, but rather it is the integration of existing methods that people are already familiar with. And you may even have implemented one or more of them in your organizations. You've probably read about them in magazines. The problem is, organizations implement these methods in isolation of each other. You have the balanced scorecard people in one building, you've got the cost accounting people in another building, you've got the budgeting people in another building, and you get a lot more synergy and power when you integrate these methods seamlessly like gears in a machine, and even more power when you embed analytics of all flavors into them, and we'll talk about that. So they're not really new, but there are pressures, and we'll talk about those pressures. Because eventually you might be able to get access to these slides, or you can email me if you go to my website at www.garykokens.com. You can send me a note, and I'll send you a PDF of them. So, but there is that definition. But notice it concludes with its purposes to achieve the strategy and make better decisions. It's all about better decision making. So let's briefly talk about analytics since it's such a hot topic. And there's also confusion and lack of consensus about it. Is business analytics a data warehouse? Is it about data mining with query and reporting, you know, the ability to drill down to a line item of an invoice or a purchase order? Is it business intelligence with some sort of enhancements? And in a few seconds, I'm going to describe the difference between business intelligence and business analytics. They're not the same thing. Is it the technology of data governance, data management, and data quality? Yes, but that's kind of an IT, you know, in the glass room, you know, kind of keeping the lights on, keeping the processes going. Is it probabilities and statistics like regression and correlation analysis or forecasting and optimization equations? And I know some of the older people that are listening to this webinar took those courses in college and you just wanted a passing grade and get out of there because it was too tough. Well, sorry, it's here. But the good news is you don't have to have mastery with those type of techniques. But you do need some people in your organization that have the capabilities, as we'll discuss in a second, because analytics, I believe, will be a competitive advantage. So it's really all more. What's the definition? Oh, I could have gone to Wikipedia and put a definition there, or I could have taken a quote out of Tom Davenport's, Professor Tom Davenport of Babson College, who wrote kind of the breakthrough book, Competing on Analytics. You can look them up on Amazon. But rather than give you a definition, I just think it's best to think about, work backwards with the end in mind. Think about a problem or an opportunity where analytics can play a role. And regardless how analytics should be defined, there should be no argument as to what is its purpose, and it's simple, better decisions and better actions. Business analytics goals should be to gain insights and foresight and solve problems to make better and quicker decisions with more accurate and fact-based data and to take actions. So I sort of lied. I said I wouldn't give you a definition, but that last paragraph's pretty good. So what about the difference between business intelligence and business analytics? Business intelligence reporting consumes stored information. Business analytics produces new information from the stored information. So business analytics is actually a stage above BI. BI was very popular a decade ago, but now it's pretty much being relegated to reporting. And then the enterprise performance management methods, which we'll describe in this webinar, they will deploy different types of analytics in the context of different types of problems. And I'll give a few examples during my talk. Insights and actions. Queries simply answer questions. Business analytics creates questions. Further, analytics then stimulate more questions, more complex questions, and more interesting questions. And most importantly, business analytics also has the power to answer the questions. And I like to get a little serious here. When I reflect on my 40-year career, because you could tell from my graduation date, 71, you know, I'm 66. My grandsons are 13 and 16, so I'm at a different stage of life. But when I look back, I think that the best executives and the best leaders have the best answers. Today, I don't think that's the case. I think today the best leaders and the best executives have the best questions. There is way too much volatility, uncertainty, and complexity for those executives to rely on their gut feel and intuition or so-called sixth sense or wisdom or their past experiences to make the decisions that got them promoted to the high levels they're at now. I think the best executives are going to create a culture for analytics that involves investigation and discovery, tolerance for error, as long as you make to learn lessons from that error. And they need to create that culture. So, a little bit of humor here. There is a Hollywood celebrity who actually, at the beginning of their career, with their publicity agent, used analytics that furthered their career. And what they did is